Hey, I'm Elliot, and I wanted to give you a comparison of three different forearm crutches that I've been using over the past few years. I have hereditary spastic paraplegia, and I use these crutches for balance, for a little bit of weight bearing, and generally just to help me walk. So the first pair of crutches I wanted to show you was the standard forearm crutch that you can get at pretty much any medical supply store. These run for somewhere between $100 and $200. And they're pretty much, what you might get discharged from the hospital or something with. These come with a standard tip. It's very small and it becomes brittle over time. I don't know if you can see that, but I've had these for a couple years now. There you go. And the rubber does crack on those. A pretty uncomfortable grip up here and a standard front-facing cuff. So these are great for a first pair of crutches when you want to dial in exactly the size and the length between your cuff and your grip, and then the grip to the tip. But they are really loud. Every time you walk on these, you can hear all the little jangling metal pieces in it, and it just really, it's not a very subtle way of getting around, I'll say. The top grip, which is standard on most of these crutches, the top cuff, I mean to say, isn't really great either. I think that the three-quarter cuff offers just as much stability side to side. And the issue with this is if I'm going to open a door or something, and I, raise my arm, my wrist falls through, and the crutch falls to the ground. Which is both annoying and a little bit unsafe because I've got a crutch on the ground. I have to go to the ground, pick it up, and move on. So I almost never use these. These are my backup pair. That's it. They're totally fine for a first pair of crutches. Now, if you're looking to, really upgrade, then two of the best crutches on the market right now are the Indesmed crutch customized by Thomas Fetterman, which is this one. And these side sticks. This one. I've had a couple pairs of side sticks now. This is my second, and I more recently got this. So I'll take you through the same information that I did on the first one. Side sticks have any type of cuff you would want. If you want it cut right off here and just a three-quarter, you can do that. If you want the traditional front-facing, you can do that. And then my personal favorite is the three-quarter. Where the opening is on the inside of the arm. They come with thin grips. Side Six has done a lot of research and design over the years, and they've come up with this fantastic grip that covers your whole inner palm, and it distributes weight really fantastically. These are my absolutely favorite pair of grips, and if you can see here, you can remove the grip entirely, and it exposes a tube that's compatible with any bike grip. Side Six used to ship their crutches with Ergon bike grips as a standard, but you can totally go crazy and use whatever you want. The Ergon ones are great too. Best part of these Side Six is the shock absorber. It's an elastomer shock absorber. It is really reliable. It doesn't have that pogo effect that cheaper crutches with shock absorbers have. It works reliably, and it really, really helps to dissipate that wrist pain and shoulder pain that a lot of long-term crutch users experience. Now at the bottom, you've got your tip inserted into a smaller tube that feeds into this general lower tube. And this is great because if I want to, if I'm going on a hike and I notice that I'm about to go uphill for a long period of time, I'm gonna go ahead and shorten this by an inch or two so that I don't have to have my grip be so high that it's uncomfortable for that period of time. And then likewise, if I'm going downhill for a while, I'll go ahead and extend this to maybe 3 or 4 inches so that I don't have to reach down as far and risk my balance by having to lean so far in front. I've got Tornado standard tips made by Thomas Fetterman on these, and I think these are the best tips on the market right now. And I've got aluminum lower tubes. Side Six come standard with carbon fiber, I believe, which are going to bring the weight down on this a bit. But as it is, this crutch and this crutch are pretty much the same weight. And then the third crutch I've got is the newest one I have, the Indismed crutch, made in Spain, customized in Philadelphia by Thomas Fetterman, who makes the best crutch tips on the market. This one has a super similar cuff. It's a slightly different, but same idea, three-quarter cuff. It has this grip that if you loosen it, you can move it up and down this carbon fiber tube. The tube is not cylindrical. It's actually wider here, thinner on front. And that's great for looking cool. I mean, it's really cool to have crutches that have a really slim profile. So I really like that. But they do not have the same aftermarket adjustability options that the Side 6 do. And these grips, grips themselves are not as comfortable as the Side 6. And I've got Tornado Air tips on these, also made by Thomas Fetterman, which are the lighter version of the standard Tornado tips. I like them for the weight, but I think that the standard Tornado tips, which are a little heavier, grip uneven surfaces a lot better. Thomas Fetterman also makes rain tips, all sorts of different things, so you can try them out and pick whatever you'd like. And these, between these two, this crutch is a whole lot heavier than this crutch. This crutch is ridiculously light. You can pick it up and it feels like it's barely even there, and that's awesome. This crutch is, I think Side 6 advertises them at about 2 pounds, but I know I've added the heavier Tornado tip and the aluminum tube, and I would be surprised if this was anything less than 5 pounds. That's fine with me. I've got full upper body strength, so that works for me. Both of these crutches have cuffs that you can adjust, both by taking out the leather insert, or by putting them in the oven for a while, not too long, and then you can actually expand them and contract them. I live in California right now, but back when I lived on the East Coast, I really liked that adjustability because I could, in the winter, make these just a little bit bigger to account for puffy jackets and things like that. Or if I'm going skiing, I can, you know, account for the added volume of my clothes, which is great. But again, you can just pull this out. This Side 6 tip attachment is really fantastic because they also sell things like sand tips, which are great for the beach, snow tips, great for the snow, hiking tips, which rotate and have a little bit of a bite to the bottom. I don't use them because I use Side 6 for balance, and then it rotates, so it just wouldn't be great for me. But if you don't have those issues and you want to have an efficient swing through gate and you really want to pendulum through it, that's a fantastic. And then another cool thing is that because this is removable, I can actually modify these for when I want to go skiing and I want to make these into outriggers. I can switch out the grip, I can switch out the bottom, and I've got myself a pair of outriggers there. So as you saw a minute or two ago, this fell apart. This isn't really a reflection on Thomas Fetterman or Indismed. Thomas Fetterman takes the crutches from Indismed and then customizes them, adding their own cuff and then a tip and cutting it to size. I think that's awesome. And in terms of customer service, I did about 2 weeks after I got this, this cuff and this tube separated from each other. I contacted them and almost immediately they said, hey, send them back to us, you know, we'll either fix them or replace them, no problem. I wanted to make this review to show you kind of what that looked like, but I think it's a super simple fix. I'm just going to go really glue it back on. It's going to be just like new. So no issues with the customer service for Thomas Fetterman there. A little disappointing that that happened within a couple weeks, but, you know, it's not that big of a deal. Side 6 customer service is just as fantastic. I've emailed them over the years about all sorts of questions, maintenance questions I had. I asked them about the outrigger thing and they got back to me like the next day. And they're really fantastic. One cool thing that they did was when I went to order my second pair of crutches, they actually already had my measurements saved from the first pair. And so I wanted to do things a little bit differently. I wanted a slightly lower tube on the second crutches so that I could have more adjustability going up and down hills. But they reached out and they said, "Hey, your overall, your lower tube crutch length looks different the second time around than the first time around. Is that a mistake, or did you really want it that way?" So just the fact that they pulled up my records and were able to have a conversation with me and make sure that, I was getting exactly what I needed, that was really awesome. So, to be honest, the crutch that I end up going for more on a day-to-day basis is going to be the Indesmed because it's so light. I can pick it up easier. I can take it out of my car easier. It just feels nice to use. And because it's carbon fiber, it doesn't get as dinged up as the aluminum powder-coated side sticks. I just feel a little bit more professional in my day-to-day using these than these. That said, if I'm gonna walk any distance at all, I'm saying like more than a couple blocks, I'm picking up my side sticks because of how comfortable they are. They might be heavier, but they're saving my shoulders and wrists a whole lot more than these might. So if I'm doing anything rigorous at all, I'm using the side sticks. If I'm just walking around my apartment or I'm going into a store and out, I'm probably gonna use these. The side sticks retails for about maybe a little bit under $800 US dollars, and then the Indesmed Thomas Fetterman retails I think for about 850 or 900 or so. So they're really comparable in price, and that's about it. Really, I mean, the most important thing if you want to save your wrists and feel more stable on crutches, and you don't have $800 to spend. So get yourself a pair of standard tornado tips. These are the best tips on the market. They last for a really, really long time. These tips were beat up after I had to use these as a backup because I forgot these in the car. I went on a hike with these, and they were pretty much trashed after one hike. And the Tornado Air, while lighter, just doesn't offer the same shock absorbing and stability benefits that the standard one does. So, all in all, if you're looking to upgrade your setup and you only have about $50 to spend, pick yourself up a pair of Tornado standard tips, and you definitely won't be disappointed.